Now moving on to our fourth speaker for the evening. She is an architect and a design entrepreneur. She has a degree in architecture and master's in historic building conservation from Edinburgh College of Art, Scotland, and has a strong design base, not only in contemporary architecture, but also in renovation. Please help me welcome architect Unnati Pingle. Good evening.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak at this prestigious platform. It's quite an honor to do so, considering I was invited by my first teacher and mentor, Ms. Aparna Bidarkar. Thank you, ma'am. So about me, I'm going to be keeping it short, crisp, and very quick. My design career has been no mean feat. The journey has been a process of vision, ambition, impediments, and the result. A process that as a designer, I cherish. I'm going to take you through a visual journey and lots of quotes. And I am going to read a lot because I think I've written it really well. Chapter one, the modest beginnings as a design student began at J&TU College of Fine Arts that gave me the foundation I needed to have a vision in the design field. There was no looking back since. At a very young age, I developed a compassion for old buildings that needed care and attention. I went on to do my master's in historic building conservation in Edinburgh College of Art, home to conservation of old buildings. Here is where chapter two of my design journey started. The blissful few years in Scotland gave me the access and privilege to travel around the continent, which I exploited to the fullest. Those years were like living your architectural life all over again, this time visually more appetizing. I was married by then, so the most natural step to follow was to expand the family. Of course, career definitely followed. I went on to work with my mentor and guide, Mr. Yashwant Ramurthy sir, whose wealth of knowledge and experience is exactly what I needed to continue my journey as a designer. The process at this point was slow. I believed in his prudent principles, which have played a major part in the entrepreneur I am today. Before I go down to chapter three of my journey, mustn't I forget to mention the prologue of my story, which is my life as a kid. Growing up in the most venturous and flamboyant way as an army kid that has played a prominent role in shaping me in who I am today. Obstacles. I think it's quite overrated. Being a mother and a family woman never deterred me from following my dreams and vision. These two, thankful and grateful to them, my lifeline, people say I'm a great mother, but the truth is that I have fabulously wonderful children. If not for their understanding and support, I wouldn't be what I am today. My journey through my family life has been strong, but strong, steady. Gave me ample of time to develop on my skills as a designer, as a leader, and as an entrepreneur. A design entrepreneur is born. A quick look at some of my works that blow me away even today. For the simple reason that the process behind each of them have been enlightening, inspiring, and breathtaking. The process of understanding requirements, accommodating the same, and creating aesthetically beautiful spaces with great drama and great finishes. There has been an indirect sense of joy in accomplishing them. That's some of my works. So the chapter four is the leader and the learning. Through the calmer years of working with some pet projects and freelancing, is when I realized that design is not all about looks, but also its functions. Details are what make good design. Striving for finishes and colors enhance my design sensibilities, which is why I also realized that vibrant shades are scene stealers for every age and happy homes. That's another project of mine. Bold hues, colors that fit together like pieces of puzzle, cogs in a wheel, become the perfect backdrop for functional yet fun spaces. I believe that home should be an extension of the personality of the person inhabiting the space. We as designers play a role of merely a moderator in helping or assisting the clients achieve their dreams. Chapter 5, Creating Moments and Memories. It is this story and mysteriously delightful maze trailing it that has confirmed in finding my niche in designing residential spaces, personalizing and styling them. The journey since has been fruitful and rewarding. As a designer, I have always believed that whatever the shell may be, it possesses the scope to recreate drama, re-energize the environment, and reinvent strategically aesthetic spaces to the current requirements. That said by Albert Einstein, I strongly believe in that. Chapter 6, Just Go. As a designer, I have discovered my skill set via my travels and varied experiences, which I consciously intend to contribute to the design sense in this city. My interest in color, culture, and travel inspire my design sensibilities. Extensive traveling has also inspired the style of design and my thinking. There are more than a few buildings that inspire me. The simplicity of Scandinavian architecture and Japanese architecture overwhelms me. On the other hand, the most effortless fusion of old and new enamors me as well. The care and sensitivity some people take to treat their buildings and spaces is fascinating. The job satisfaction I get in architecture and designing spaces is immense. It's long and laborious, but helping someone design their space is heartwarming. Chapter 7, Theory. Another baby is born. Theory was transpired out of the uncharted. It's a process of growth, influx of creative ideas, and in this organic progression, curating bespoke pieces of art. Each fragment of these pieces of art, as I would like to call them, is unique and exquisite, with no attempts spared at immaculate finishes. However, the high point of theory by the end of the process was instilling life into pieces that once adorned homes, cherished, and now in a state of apathy. This appealed to me, and I continued the journey for a year until I had a collection of work of art. I was so gratified of this achievement that I decided to exhibit it one fine day. Design ideology behind theory is the whimsical bit. It's quite mysterious. It's a fusion of concepts put together, hence theory. Theory is, and hopefully will always remain, an amalgamation of finest artists, great artisans, a creative brain, and some fabulous friends as support, which I trust and strongly believe that is the basis of any design process to be accomplished. I would like to keep theory the way it is, with no orderliness, no method to the madness, but with a goal to create. Very centric to my personality, my frame of mind at that moment, and my resilience, which is in abundance. Keep at it, with an endeavor of churning out some magnificent pieces of art through a natural course of time. Curating work of art for me now is going into a maze and coming out with some magnificent pieces of art. To sum it all up, I strongly believe that design is a silent ambassador of your brand. So work hard, dream big, and never give up. That's me. Done. Thank you.